What I want to do in this video is get some practice visualizing what happens if we were to try to rotate two-dimensional shapes in three dimensions. What do I mean by that? Let's say I started with a right triangle. So let's say my right triangle looks like this. So let's say it looks like that right over there. And so this is a right angle. And let's say that this width right over here is 3 units. And let's say that this length is 5 units. And now I'm going to do something interesting. I'm going to take this two-dimensional right triangle, and I'm going to try to rotate it in 3 dimensions around this line, around the line that I'm doing as a dotted magenta line. So I'm going to rotate it around this line right over there. So if I were to rotate it around this line, what type of a shape am I going to get? And I encourage you, once again, it's going to be a three-dimensional shape, and I encourage you to think about it. Maybe take out a piece of paper, draw it, or just try to imagine it in your head. Well, to think about it in 3 dimensions, what I'm going to do is try to look at this thing in 3 dimensions. So let me draw this same line, but I'm going to draw it at an angle so we can visualize the whole thing in 3 dimensions. So imagine if this was sitting on the ground. So that's our magenta line. And then I can draw my triangle. So my triangle would look something like this. So it would look like this. So once again, this is 5 units, this is 3 units, this is a right triangle. I'm going to rotate it around the lines. What's it going to look like? Well, this end right over here is going to rotate around, and it's going to form a circle with a radius of 3, right? So it's going to form, so when it intersects, if that was on the ground, it's going to be 3 again. And let me draw it down, so it's going to keep going down. Whoops, I don't want to press the wrong button. So it's going to look something like this. That's what the base is going to look like. But then this end right over here is just going to stay at a point, because this is right on that magenta line. So it's just going to stay at a point. And so if you were to look at the intersection, so it would look something like this. So it would look like this, and then you'd have another thing that goes like this. And so if you were to take a section like this, you would have a little smaller circle here based on what this distance is. So what is the shape? What is the shape that I am drawing? Well, what you see, what it is, it's a cone. It's a cone. And if I shade it in, you might see the cone a little bit better. So let me shade it in. So you see the cone. So what you end up getting is a cone where its base, so I'm shading it in, so that hopefully helps a little bit. So what you end up getting is a cone where the base has a radius of 3 units. So let me draw this. So this right over here is the radius of the base, and it is 3 units. I could also draw it like this. So the cone is going to look like this, and this is the tip of the cone, and it's going to look just like this. And once again, let me shade it a little bit so that you can appreciate that this is a three-dimensional shape. So draw the cone so you can shade it. And we can even construct the original so that, well, or we can construct this original shape so you see how it constructs. So it makes this. The line, that magenta line, is going to do this type of thing. It's going to go through the center of the base. It's going to go through the center of the base, just like that. And our original shape, our original right triangle, if you just took a cross section of it that included that line, you would have your original shape. Let me do this in orange. So the original shape is right over there. So what do you get? You get a cone where the radius of the base is 3 units. Interesting.